Hi and welcome to another video. My name is Torge Pedersen from the Software Solution Services PAE group, and in this video I would like to show some general requirements and procedures to be followed while working on display migration projects. Display migration projects took place if display hardware change is required, like from older DP250, DP6 or 700 displays to newer DM430 or DM10 and 1200 displays with all their new functionalities and higher resolutions, or even a DP change from classic screen to the more flexible vector-based screen editor. The main focus during this migration is inside the screen editor to create an application for a +1 graphical terminal. Older DP displays use the classic screen editor, where newer displays use the vector-based screen editor. I will show all aspects of changes and challenges faced while working on a display migration project. The content of this video, starting with an overview or principles of the project migration: what is the input and what is the output, what are the assumptions, scalability and the image size, followed by the process changes, including signal naming, create separate pages and components related to specific screens, adding images to screen using libraries, adjusting the image settings like pixel ratio and transparency, and recalculating the X and Y coordinates to fit a new screen size without compromising resolution. At the end, I will mention some challenges and differences between classic and vector-based screen editor. The principles of my video example is to migrate a DP250 screen to a DM430 display 1-to-1. The goal is taking the original DP250 project and then modify the components of screen to fit with new DM430 screen display. The resolution of DP250 is 320 to 240 pixels, whereas resolution of DM430 is 480 to 272 pixels. To have a one-to-one migration, there will be a need to add a resolution factor for the X and Y coordinates. Creating screens for DM430, which are similar to screens in DP250 without changing code logic, so the main changes will take place inside the screen editor. As already mentioned, one main point which needs to be considered is the different resolutions, so-called scalability. So 320 to 240 on the DP250, whereas resolution of DM430 is 480 to 272 pixels. All components needs to fit in new screen size without compromising resolution. Therefore, calculating delta X and delta Y is needed. We will take a look later when it comes to screen editor and adding the images. The old display project code, which needs to be migrated to a newer display, will be the basis of this video example migration project. So the DP250 code is the input. Output will be the newer display screens, which appear exactly the same as DP250 display screens. In this case, it would be code that will be compatible to fit in the DM430 display. And as an assumption point, all components will be placed at exactly same locations as in DP250, and code logic is not to be changed, as it may affect functioning of machine or display insignificant information. After clarifying the principles and the goal of the migration, we can start doing process changes. I open the DP project and the first change takes place inside guide drawing related to classic and vector-based screen editor difference to instantiate a screen definition. Inside the DP project, all definitions and area pages needs to be removed from the code. These components relates to the classic screen. After this, the modified project can be compiled and closed afterwards. To have access to the STS file and images as well in the following migration steps, the project should not be closed as P1P. Now a new project can be created with the appropriate DM HWD and template. And I start by comparing inputs and outputs of DM430 with DP250. Each signal in DM430 should be named same as in DP250, otherwise the code logic will break due to either signal not found or signal mismatch errors. For example, in inputs of DM430, the pin buttons have default signal names in template like button 1, button 2, while in DP250 inputs, the pin buttons have signals named software underline soft 1, 2, and so on. In DM430, we extended button 1, 2, 3, and 4 with aliases as software underline soft 1, 2, 3, and 4, respectively. You can use the feature view logic net to change the port names easily. And after routing the IOs to the corresponding application signal, the code should compile without errors. Next step inside process changes is to add a show screen component in the page where the definitions and error pages were removed. Query the show screen component and create new screen definition. Add necessary bus inputs, which makes signals available in the screen editor. In some projects on older displays, all screens were on one single page. Therefore, the components were mixed and could be difficult to be identified. To provide a better solution, it is recommended to create separate pages for each screen and add all components related to a specific screen. After adding the show screen components and bus inputs, you can start adding the DP images. To do so, it is recommended to create a new library which grouped images and texts to be shown on different screens. Add up images to the library by creating new folders as required. As I already mentioned, DP project must not be closed as PMP to assess the images. For each image added in library, you must verify its properties, that it has same pixel ratio and transparency as in original DP project. This is done by double click on the image. A new pop-up edit image is shown in screen editor, and here you can set the image format, pixels, and its transparency. It should be same as in DP project, such as gauge needles must have an insertion point. Text components can be created in screen library by right-clicking on library folder and select new text option. It will open the text editor window. Some components may combine two or more values, such as hour format. It can be represented as AM and PM both. To show a specific time, you can create text list, which will contain both text values as AM and PM. Similarly, speed can be represented in kilometer per hour or miles per hour. You can create separate text list to switch between representation of speed. Similar to text list, there could also be the need to have image list in screen editor. For example, components such as temperature and all gauges that could have three values to show on screen. For example, if it's red, if temperature is high, white, if it's normal, and blue, if the temperature is low. So therefore, create an image list in screen library by right-clicking on screen library and select new image list. It will open pop-up of edit image list where you can choose images to be added to the image list. Once finished creating library of images and text, you can start adding components from library to each screen. For each component in the screen, you may recalculate the X and Y coordinates to place it at correct position on the new display screen, like the DM430 screen in my example. In order to place image components of the DP250 to fit perfectly in my new display DM430, multiply delta x with the x coordinates of image in DP250 and the delta y with the y coordinates of image in DP250 through the inspector window of the plus one screen editor. There might be images that are used to express maximum and minimum values of components like gauges, progress bar, and brightness slider. Recalculate the offset of components and status bar by determining starting position of first component in status bar screen. After placing each component on its required place, you must assign signals to it. These signals are used to trigger components. They will decide when to show which component on the display. In case of image list and text list, they will have more than one component to show on screen. You can also set default component to be shown on display when an image list is enabled. This can be done by setting the active index signal in inspector window. The active index property has two fields, signal and constant. This constant will have a numeric value that will correspond to index of component in the list. In the same way we set layout for text list, you can decide where the text should be aligned, the font style, font size, and the font color. There might also be a few images in your project that are rotated when triggered by some signal. The rotation angle can be set through the inspector window of the screen editor as well. You can drag line and place it on the component you desire. Lines can be stretched and contracted. Once a line is dropped on the screen, it will be added to the list of components in the screen manager. You can rename and also assign color and width to lines. If you use components that represent maximum and minimum values, for example, temperature and speed gauge, screen brightness, regeneration progress bar, and so on, the max and mean values are updated to match the coordinates with DM430 screen. Both these values should not show beyond the screen limits, so vertical limits are recalculated using the delta Y, whereas horizontal limits are calculated using the delta X. To verify that you have added all signals that are linked to specific screens, there is a drop-down field in the Screen Manager window inputs. At the end of this video, I will like to show some challenges and differences which may have effect in your migration project as well. Projects and older displays like the DP250 might have its own font for text. These fonts are installed through guide but did not reflect in the menu where we can choose fonts. The solution for this is to add fonts to your computer Windows fonts folder. Then you will be able to choose DP250 fonts in guide text editor menu. As you add images from screen library, the size of image might get changed. The solution for this is, after adding image from screen library to desired screen, resize the image dimensions from inspector window if required. Another difference of the classic screen editor and the vector-based screen editor is the data formatting. Data value formatting in classic screen editor for input uses the characters %d, whereas the formatting in vector-based screen editor use $1. We hope that you found this tutorial useful. Remember that +1 community help is available on the +1 user forum. Check out other videos on our YouTube channel or contact the +1 helpdesk. Thank you for your attention.